Tomorrow is weekend. Let's hang out somewhere.
Okay, so let's meet at 12 o'clock tomorrow. Is that okay?
Well, it's too late. Why don't we meet earlier?
You don't understand that. Today is 冬至. You should sleep more for your health.
Is there a saying for that?
Of course. It's related to 24 solar terms.
On November the 30, 2015, China's declaration of 24 solar terms, times knowledge system and practice formed by Chinese people through observing the annual movement of the sun was officially included in the representative list of the intangible cultural heritage of humanity. According to the Big Dipper, Asian people guide the agricultural production in the night sky. The 24 solar terms are China's fifth invention in the international meteorological community. It is not only a season system for guiding agricultural production, but a folk system with rich folk customs. The 24 solar terms reflect the changes of the seasons and affect the food, clothing, housing, and transportation of millions of households. In this video, we will learn about the winter solstice. In Chinese, we call it 冬至, one of the 24 solar terms.
冬至, the 冬至 is also called the winter festival. It's one of the 24 solar terms. Cold weather is the most obvious feature of entering the 冬至. It represents the arrival of 暑酒, which is the coldest days. At this time, the weather becomes colder and dry. The humidity is relatively low, but it's also the time that humans' body's yang is the weakest. At the same time, the yin is the strongest. So this solar term is more suitable for health preservation. There's an old saying goes that keep healthy during winter days in exchange for a healthy coming year. The winter here refers to the 冬至. Indeed, it's cold, so it's particularly important to keep warm, especially to keep our head and feet warm. Traditional Chinese medicine shows that yang gathers in our head. Feet are the start acupoint of yin. And there's a saying goes that the cold comes from the foot. So the head and feet are easier to feel the invasion of cold. So we need to dress appropriately according to the temperature change. It's important to keep our body warm and yet do not get overreacted because excessive sweating. There's a saying in traditional Chinese medicine called yang sui jin tuo, which means if you sweat too much, you will also lose too much yang along with the sweat. In our daily life, we should go to bed early and get up late. Go to bed early can stabilize the yang in our body. Get up late can balance our yin essence. Also, reduce unnecessary outdoor activities in order to prevent the excessive consumption of yang. Keep a regular diet is to attain mental tranquility. Have a balanced work is to store our physical energy. Winter is the season of resting. Exercise should also confirm the laws of nature. We should not exercise too much. The sunny time is the best time for exercise, such as 9 to 10 a.m. in the morning and 2 to 3 p.m. in the afternoon. It's better to do some stretch sports, such as jogging, doing tai chi, and Ba Duan Jin Qi Gong. Winter is rather cold, so it's better to eat warm food such as mutton, beef, and fish. Meanwhile, we need to prevent from eating salty food and have some bitter food, so that our kidney won't get heated. We could also eat some food that belongs to yin that can help us nourishing our kidney, such as fungus, sesame, black beans, turtles, and so on. In the end, I'll teach you two acupoints that is good for our kidney and our physical health. The first is called Guan Yuan, the other is called Ming Men. Guan Yuan is about 10 centimeters under our belly button, and Ming Men is under the second lumbar protrusion of the back spine. It's easy to find Guan Yuan. It's about 4 fingers wide under the belly button, and Ming Men is easier. It's on the spot right behind our belly button on our back. These two acupoints is perfectly for acupuncture, and it's also used if we just rub it directly.
I just heard the expert say, in different solar terms, we eat different food. This also has something to do with our health.
Yes. On the day of 冬至, almost every Chinese family will eat dumplings.
Well, I know we have to eat dumplings during Spring Festival. But I don't know we have to eat this in 冬至.
Of course, there is still a beautiful story about it.
In North China, there is a custom. Every family eats dumplings on the day of Dongzhi. It is said that this custom is to memorialize Zhang Zhongjing. Zhang is one of the most eminent Chinese physicians. Legend says that Zhang came back to Nanyang after retirement. He was gloomy when he found the villagers' ears frozen in that cold winter. So Zhang Zhongjing ordered his students to put up some shafts to practice medicine. Zhang placed meat, chilies, and some Chinese herbal medicine into the boiled water. After cooking, get out of the pot and chop. Then Zhang rammed the ingredients with piece of dough, and he shipped each one as an ear. After boiling, this kind of new food was done, dumplings. The villagers' ears were cured after eating dumplings. From then on, every Dongzhi, people will imitate Zhang's step to cook, forming the customs of eating dumplings.
咱们这个包饺子首先要揉面，面粉呢用普通的中筋面粉就可以，或者用烤面包的高筋面粉也可以。面团呢稍微要柔软一些。面团揉好后需要醒松半小时，接下来就要擀饺子皮了。第一步就是揪剂子。
揪剂儿有什么讲究吗？
就是快很准，就是这个拖拉拉的感觉揪得不均匀。
左手托起长条，用左手大拇指和食指握住面头，左手保持不动，用右手大拇指底部内侧一边辅助食指，快速的做切面动作，然后撒上面粉，用手轻轻的按着它们，将它们揉圆。
现在就是这把它按平了，对，压平，因为很容易好擀，
就可以用擀面杖擀成水饺皮了。
擀的时候有什么技巧吗？
擀饺子皮的时候呢，右手拿擀面杖，左手拿一个剂子，从边缘向圆心擀，右手擀，左手逆时针旋动饺子皮，
要跟着右手，擀一下就转一下，
擀一下转一下，
对，擀一下转一下，擀上两边薄，周围薄，中间稍微厚一点，这个包出来饺子不容易破，
且要不断的更换位置，如此进行4到5次便可擀好了。
转一下，擀一下，
对，擀一下，转一下，对，
还是两个手配合协调，
对对对对对。
教教我说咱们这个怎么给它包成一个完整的饺子。
首先把饺子皮放在手上，然后放入适量的调馅，对折，将两侧饺子皮的中间捏合，用双手的虎口部位将它们向中间方向夹紧，这样饺子就包好了，准备开煮。
我刚看您这个做的感觉挺简单，挺轻松的。
对对 对，
我也说来试试。
哎，可以可以可以可以可以，
新手啊，
太多了太多了
太多了，
对，太多了，
这样呢？
也多
啊，有点还是多。
对，下手多了一点
啊。
好，可以了可以了可以了。
咱们这一定要适量是吧？
对对对，要对。
完之后呢，就对折。
对对折。
对折一下。
大拇指放大拇指中间。
大拇指中间这样的。
握着跟握拳似的
啊，
放在虎口
啊，直接这样放。
对，两个大拇指往中间一挤
啊，这样一挤，
哎，
这个就挺好，我以后要多加练习。
好，
咱们先烧水，等水烧开后放入饺子，一定要记住要搅动一下，不要让饺子粘在一起了。等到锅里水开了，放一大勺冷水。之后再等它煮开。饺子煮熟的标志为饺子浮出水面，大头朝上，这时就可以捞出来了。
Is that good?
Yeah, of course. You know, eating...Our homemade dumplings feels actually very different.
Of course, eating dumplings in Dongzhi is a sign for Chinese people to pay attention to the nutrition balance, because there is a meat, vegetables, and carbohydrate.
Yeah, of course, I know that. So eating dumplings in winter, you know, the atmosphere, the temperature is getting low. So eating dumplings is very good for, you know, our health.
Yeah, Actually, in Dongzhi, we eat very important, but actually we have to pay attention to our health, to do some exercise or other things, not only in the eating.
After hearing this, we still have a lot to be prepared. Let's get ready and welcome the cold winter.
And in the next video, we'll talk about 小雪. If you want to know more about healthy tips and healthy Chinese food, don't forget to follow us.
I'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.